afternoon, everyone. If you didn't already know, October is Domestic Violence Awareness Month. And for Domestic Violence Awareness Month, the Shelter for Abused Women and Children has put together a 5-day web series called Ending the Silence to highlight important topics surrounding domestic violence. So thank you for joining our 4th day of our 5-day web series. Today we have Lori Zanelli. Lori is our Healing Arts Advocate at the Shelter for Abused Women and Children. Lori, thank you so much for joining us today.
It's a pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Absolutely. Lori, can you tell us a little bit about what the Healing Arts program is?
Sure. So the Healing Arts program, first off, I wanted to say that we are one of very few in the country. So we're very blessed here to have this program in our with our facility.
That's amazing.
Yeah, it really is. Some of the things that we offer here are yoga. Mm-hmm. We do crystal bowl healing. Mm-hmm. We work with art therapy. We do drumming. We have, talk to them about nutrition, eating mm-hmm. healthy, how that can help, you know, with what they've got going on. Mm-hmm. We do book reviews. Mm-hmm. We have groups and I see people individual.
I love that. That's wonderful. So many things that you offer in this program. Yeah. So I know that the community has submitted a few questions in regards to the Healing Arts program. So I'd like to ask you some of those questions, if that's
sure.
okay. So one of the questions that was submitted to us was, what activities do you do with the participants and what purpose do those activities serve?
Sure. So just say, for instance, yoga. Mm-hmm. There's so many different yoga poses out there. Some of the yoga poses that we work with will either, you know, calm somebody down, but some of the other ones can, you know, kind of energize them. Mm-hmm. So if someone came to me and said they were suffering from depression, I'm not going to put them into poses where they fold forward. They're already closed up. I'm going to put them into poses that open their heart to bring energy in, mm-hmm. to open that chest center. If someone comes in suffering from anxiety, mm-hmm. a lot of, you know, stress and tension, and they're really feeling worked up, they're the ones that I'm going to put into poses that fold forward mm-hmm. to kind of close them up a little bit to quell that energy. Mm-hmm. So we're able to, you know, kind of individualize the yoga program. Wonderful. Breathing techniques, for instance. I love breathing techniques because they're free. Mm-hmm. You can do them anywhere. And people say, well, we breathe, you mm-hmm. know, we were born breathing. But I think it's so important to really learn some of the different techniques. Some of the techniques calm the vagus nerve, mm-hmm. which will automatically calm the nervous system. So it brings them to a place of, you know, peace and feeling calm right off the bat. Mm-hmm. The crystal bowls, for instance, the sound therapy, it basically works with vibration. And if you look at things from a scientific point, we're nothing more than vibrating particles. Mm-hmm. So when we can get those vibrations into a healthy resonance, people will start to feel better. Mm-hmm. So the effects of from the crystal bowls or the vibration can be immediate. We can put them on the table and work with them for just 10 minutes and they're already feeling calmed down.
That's a really good thing. I truly, myself, I had no idea that some of these, you know, what you offer, it takes immediate effect.
Yeah. You know, some take a little bit longer. The art therapy, you know, that's something that we work with them on and it's kind of a gradual process, but they can also, you know, find even immediate release from that. Mm-hmm. Sometimes they're not able to put things into words what happened to them, mm-hmm. but we can put a paintbrush in their hand and they can, you know, scribble and just get things out on paper. Mm-hmm. And I hear so often, I'm not creative, I'm not artistic, you know, and that's not what it's about. It's mm-hmm. just about that creative outlet and getting that energy out.
It's wonderful. Really, everything that you have to offer for the participants suffering from domestic violence, it's a great thing that, you know, we're fortunate enough, like you said, that we could offer those things. Lori, if it's okay with you, our last question was really, can you show us how some of these things work?
Like, absolutely.
Can you show me how to use one?
I would love to teach you. We can teach you the crystal bowls.
All right. Wonderful. Okay, Lori, so what do we have here?
So these are the crystal bowls.
Okay.
So
they're heavy.
They are heavy. They are heavy.
So if you strike the bowl, I can feel the vibrations.
You can feel the vibrations, and it makes a sound. So each one of the crystal bowls vibrated a different hertz, a different resonance. Mm-hmm. So just by striking it, it puts out a vibration that helps to calm the body. Mm-hmm. Wow. For instance, a bowl that's 528 hertz, they say, has the ability to restructure our DNA.
That's amazing. What's something like this? What? How many hertz would a bowl like this have?
That's a little bit lower, so that's going to be about 300. Mm-hmm. So it's going to depend on the size of the bowl. I mean, behind us we have, you know, a lot of different sizes here and different pitches. So it's kind of like musical notes too. Mm-hmm. You can also make these sing.
Amazing, because I could really feel the vibrations in my hands, and it's like a feeling in here.
Yeah. So when people come in and they're suffering from, you know, trauma, stress, anxiety, this is one of the fastest ways that I've found to calm them down. Mm-hmm. I can put them on the massage table, and I mean, within a few moments, they're already at a place of peace.
I love that. I really, really do.
So these I use a lot.
This is amazing. Now, with something like this, and I know everyone's different, you know, everyone handles and deals with you know, handles trauma differently. Mm-hmm. How many sessions would it take for somebody to start feeling the effects?
Immediately.
Wow.
So a lot of times they don't need to, you know, have like an hour session, usually 5-10 minutes, and they're calmed down.
Wow. That is amazing.
Yeah.
Well, Lori, thank you so much, you know, for showing us how to use the Tibetan bowls. We
You're
truly
welcome.
Appreciate it. I'm sure the audience appreciates it as well. So, Lori, using the Tibetan bowls was a lot of fun. I really enjoyed it. What other activity do you have for us today?
Angel cards.
They are very pretty.
They are very pretty. So a lot of times I work with the people with positive affirmations, mm-hmm. working with their intuition, but also kind of rewriting that story.
Okay.
And sometimes the angel cards can give them a positive outlook on what's happening. Okay. So in our last group, we did the angel cards and taught them intuition to really trust their gut feelings. So let's do a reading for you.
All right. Show us how it works.
So basically we... you know, we just shuffle the deck, and I just kind of ask that, you know, what is it that Alina needs to know today?
Okay. This will be exciting because I don't know what's going to pop up.
So, and they're all positive. There's nothing negative that comes out of the angel cards, but we just kind of shuffle, and then when I kind of feel the right card, Earth Angel. So it says, you are a light worker who has come to Earth to teach about love.
Aww. I love that.
Yeah. I usually draw three cards, so we're going to draw two more for you.
Okay.
Sometimes, you know, a card will pop up that's maybe like inner child. Mm-hmm. And that kind of tells me, you know, that'll tell the people, you know, you need to let that inner child out. Mm-hmm. You need to be more playful, you know, not so serious about things. Solar plexus chakra. So this says it is safe for you to be powerful and take charge of your life in positive ways.
Ooh.
So there's different energy centers in the body, mm-hmm. and the solar plexus is the seat of power. So a lot of times that's, you know, powerful if they can hear that, mm-hmm. hey, you're a powerful being. You can do whatever you want to do.
I really
take control.
Like that. Like you said, take control.
Yeah.
A lot of our participants, you know, they just need that extra push to start taking control about their life again.
Cancel, clear, delete. Use only positive words and thoughts as they're rapidly manifesting into form. Ask the angels to cancel the effects of past negative thinking. So this is one that I work with them all the time. I'm mm-hmm. always telling them, you know, energy follows intention. What you think, you get back.
Mm-hmm.
You know, ask and you shall receive. So I'm mm-hmm. really, you know, I really push that with the people.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to use the word push, but I really, you know, talk to them about, be really careful about what you're thinking about.
Mm-hmm.
Be careful about what you're talking about putting out there.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that's a great one.
Oh, absolutely. I love that. This is a lot of fun.
Yeah.
This is a lot of fun. Lori, thank you so much for, you know, taking the time and showing us all the different activities that you do with our participants. I definitely had a lot of fun with you today.
Thank you. It's a pleasure.
I want to thank Lori for sharing such valuable information today. I'm sure that we all learned something new. I know that it could be difficult for victims to get help. Thankfully, the Shelter for Abused Women and Children has a 24/7 hotline and text line to make it a bit easier for victims to reach out. If you or someone you know is going through domestic violence, you can use the number on the screen to call or text the Shelters for Abused Women and Children's hotline. When you call, an advocate will best assist you. Together, we must all prevent, protect, and prevail against domestic violence to ensure a safe home for all.